Let me show you the solution. I was going to do this in two separate videos. Now I'm going to make it into one. I'm going to show you the secrets of Magnepan's setup. How to set up Maggies once and for all the right way. So let's pause this for a second. Okay, so let me go back. I'm going to play this. Well, I just turned it down. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to do two samples. I'm going to play this thing again, a little bit louder. And I want you to just listen through the vocal. Just listen. There'll be a vibration through the whole vocal, the whole thing. And then let me do this thing that we had before, we listened to before, at right at 125. Okay, and she's gonna say something about, let's see. Okay, so she's gonna say, "We see through the stars." I want you to listen to the word stars when she says that and listen to how it vibrates. See. Right when she says stars. We see through the stars. Burning in the atmosphere. Okay, so you probably heard that right when she said stars. Okay, so now what I'm gonna do is now I'm gonna show you what most people do. They think Maggies need subs, right? Everybody knows Maggie needs subs. Nobody knows how to use them correctly. What I see most people doing is putting in rel subs, tapping them off the back of the amp. What that means is you're not high passing the panels. So all you're doing is adding subs. So let me show you what it's like if we add subs to this. It's gonna reinforce the bass for sure. And some of the other models, from what I hear, the 0.7 was made to do strong bass. I think LRS has much less bass than these, so this is a good speaker for me to show you. Okay, so hang on one second. I'm gonna pause it while I hook up the subs. Give me one second. Okay, so now I put in these two subs that you see here, these towers. They each have a plate amp on back. These are brought in at 80 with a 24 dB slope, so third order at 80 hertz. And let's see if I have anything else. It just got some other little rumble filter and things that are set to, you know, just kind of keep it from being too boomy. And truth be told, they're a little close to the wall, but nonetheless, let's listen to what it sounds like when you add subs to Maggie's.
Different shade.
so. Try the other song. But here's where people go wrong, okay? Look at the size of those panels. Those are doing some pretty low bass. If you know how a Maggie's made, this is one membrane, okay, from left to right. It's one piece of mylar. There's ribbons that go up and down that mylar that are aluminum foil that go up. They're stuck on there, okay? That's what pulls back and forth with the magnet. If you can see those three dots there, those are like three buttons that they anchor down, okay? That anchors it to the back panel, and it holds it tight so it doesn't vibrate right where those anchors are. And that is the division between the woofer and the tweeter, are those three buttons. They're supposed to hold that down and keep it from vibrating. Now, hats off to them, man. It's a genius design. It's how they do them for this price, but it is not optimal for audio. there are better ways to do it. What you need to do, especially with your smaller mags, and I do it with any of them, think of them as a mid or a low mid and high. Do not think of them as a full range speaker. Just treat them as you would if they were mid and high. What I mean there is to cross them over actively. Okay, and that way your panels are not doing the low bass, only the subs are. Right now, even though it's fortified with bass, we're still not getting clarity in the upper register, in the vocal register, especially in the deep vocal register. So what I'm gonna do next is I'm gonna put in an active crossover, and I'm gonna cross these over at about the same, maybe 80, something like that. 24, and we're gonna go ahead and listen and see what the difference is once we pull the low bass out of the panels and we just let the subs do the low bass. Let's see what the difference is. Give me a second. Okay, so now what I've done is I've employed the use of this crossover. It's an active crossover, and we're coming out of the preamp, we're going into this piece. And then we divide it up. I'm only using the first two channels. I've got this one off. So this is a three-way. I'm not using this one. We're only using these first two. So it's high and low, and I'm crossing them over at 80 hertz with a 24 dB slope. So it's a steep slope, especially because open baffles have their own roll-off. So it adds, I think it's another 6 or maybe 12. I've got it as loud as it was before when we were playing it loud. And I did not touch, to be fair, I did not touch any of the settings on the plate amps. I left them exactly like they were. I cut the gain a little on this, on the bass, on the lows, because it was kind of a lot. So all I did was attenuate the from here, just the low out. But all the different settings and things that were on the plate amp, I didn't mess with those, so I didn't have any like unfair advantage, you know, by tuning it better or something like that. I left them identical, okay? And so this is what it sounds like when you take the bass out of the panels along with using the subs. See how tight and snappy that is up top? I'm sure you can hear how uncongested it sounds now, so clear and snappy up top. You know, I mean, the AGD amps have a good part to do with that because they're so good. But, you know, I mean, you can hear that it's been cleared away. All that kind of haze or that scrabbly stuff, I don't know what you call it, but it clouds and it muffles and it gets into the vocal. And It's when you clear it out, man. I mean, did you hear how clean those tops are? Even though the bass is super strong. And look, I'm playing it at this clip because this is where things are going to start to mess up, right? I'm not going to play it. If I play it soft, you can play anything sounds all right when it's soft. I'm pushing it up so you can, we're putting it, you know, somewhere where if there was an issue, we would hear it for sure at this volume, right? Because I'm pushing it. So let's listen to the other vocal, okay? See how clean that is? Freaking killer. sounds like a bad dream now. That's probably a pretty clear here. Magnepans are mid and high. Your lows are not in the Magnepans, even though the Maggies do lows exceptionally, like you heard these. Look, if you're a low-level listener, use these the way they are. Use them the 0.7s with no subs, just like they are. You'll get beautiful bass if you keep it at a steady level, okay? If you at all like to get it a little bit more, then you know what? Even at steady level, it still isn't going to separate like that. You're still going to have the low frequency in there vibrating. So if you're really a perfectionist, you're going to do it this way. This is the right way to do Magnepans, okay? The majority of people I see out there put REL subs with Maggies, and they just hook them up at the back of the amp. And you're not taking care of the issue. You're supplementing the bass at that point, but you are not taking care of the issue, which is the low bass or the bass in the panel, okay? It makes a huge difference. I'm sure you could hear it. It's night and day. I mean, you heard how clean and the volume we were listening was so clean. It didn't distort. It was just like, it was gorgeous. But when we had it all in the Maggie, It was smeared, it was muffled, it was muddled, it was like, yeah, you could get away with it, but if you're gonna put subs, do it the right way. I mean, you can still do it with your rails. All of you that have your rails hooked up at the back of the amp can just hook them up a different way. You don't have to get rid of them or anything like that. You just get yourself a crossover, an active crossover, and you would just feed your rail through the back, from the back of the crossover. You wouldn't take it off the amplifier, okay? You would just come out of here, line level. Your amp's gonna like it better. Your fronts are gonna like it better. It's just a way better way of doing things, okay? This is made by Marchand, Phil Marchand. I am going to have some made for us at 11 stereo that is gonna be exactly what we need for Maggie's. So it's not going to be anything extra. So we'll be able to save some money and have just what we need, a two-way that is very basic, that has, you know, exactly what we need. And I'll have those
on the 11 stereo website. Otherwise, look for an XM44 used on the used market. Find an XM44. That's what you want. Okay, you get a two-way, you can get a three-way. They have them different, you know, versions. This is an XM126. This is with vacuum tubes in there. This is a lot more expensive. It's got an outboard power supply. The XM44 is all self-contained. It uses op amps, and it's less money. So that is the secret, my friends, to Magnepan. All y'all been out there putting your rels on there, and I'm just sitting there going, yeah. Do I tell them? I don't know. Do I tell them? Yeah, I do tell them. You know why? Because I'm Mikey, and you know that's what I do. I let you guys in on the secrets. So that is how you set up Magnepans and get them dialed in. Now, if you really want to have fun, pick up some of Danny Ritchie's GR Research open baffle or their H-frame subs, because these are servo drive, which means they can keep up with the Magnepans, and the Magnepans are very fast. So are Danny's subs. These are controlled so that they can stop the woofer. It actually has something in there that will stop the woofer if it's going to go a little too flabby or something like that. It keeps it nice and tight, and it sounds beautiful, and you can tune them really well. So, and of course, the AGD amps without the AGDs. I mean, you saw we were turning it up. They don't care. These new, I'm telling you, Alberto made these two versions, man. He did some shit to them. I suggested a couple things, and I'm telling you, this guy put some juice into the new ones, man. I think you take a chick to that dinner party and you're gonna get some at the end of the night for sure. That's pretty smooth killer stuff, man. Child, you better get on board. People get ready, there's a train coming. You don't need no baggage, you just get on board. All you need is faith to hear the deep. You don't need...